Welcome back to the Pause Play Some Games. I'm your host, narrator, commentator, whatever you want me to be, Pause. Today we'll be continuing on with our story, our Let's Play Clannad, the visual novel. During our last video, we assumed the role of Tomoya Okazaki at the beginning of our story. He's a senior high school student who's fairly jaded and pretty much hates his life. He's labeled a delinquent as he's pretty much always late and often skips class. On the walk to school, one morning, pretty early in the year, he discovers a girl standing with him at the bottom of the hill. Although Tomoya is negative, pretty negative, he gives advice to the girl, and they ascend the hill to school together. We also met Yuhei Sunohara, his best friend and fellow delinquent. Our previous video ended just as we were leaving Sunohara's dorm for the evening, and we noticed his tape player. And we were given the choice to either dub something over his disgusting taste in music, or just to leave it alone and not touch it. Seeing as how Sunohara didn't have any tea for us, we're going to dub something over it. And this is where we pick up. So, let me get into this. Okay, I'll record my own original rap instead. The theme will be to my best friend, Sunohara Rap. This will definitely impress him. Here we go. I take a deep breath and press the record button. Yo, yo, I'm Okazaki, you're... With a tempo down, I begin to spin my words. You're... Damn, nothing comes to mind. That's pretty sad. Never mind, this is stupid. Say something fitting. Okay, well, this is a pretty dumb idea. Forget it. This is stupid. I throw a swift punch in frustration. Why the hell do I have to do something like this for him anyway? You didn't have to? It's not like we're close friends or anything to begin with. Yeah, he didn't have tea for us. I'm out of here. I decide to leave before Sunohara returns. The next day, April 15th. Oh, there she is. You again? Why aren't you going on ahead? Perhaps she was waiting for you.
それは、その、なんと言いますか?
It's okay. You don't have to force yourself to say it. I'm a stranger, after all.
はい。
But you know, you should be serious about going to school on time. You know, obviously, since I'm the role model, I go to school on time all the time.
遅刻してます。
Called us out on it. She points her finger at me. It's okay for me. I turn my eyes away in dramatic fashion. To begin with, what am I so serious about, lecturing a stranger? That's right, that's like she said. She's also delinquent. I don't remember her saying that. Do whatever you want. I leave her alone and start ascending the hill by myself. It's just that she doesn't look like a delinquent at all, so I felt like lecturing her. That's the only reason. Is it the only reason? Huh? Huh?
待ってください!
A voice. It's that girl's. Well, who else would it be?
ついていっていいですか?
I look back to see her standing there beside me. Wait, you look back to see her standing beside you. Why?
それは...
Perhaps she likes you. Perhaps she wants to be your friend. Did you ever think about that, Mr. Negativity?
一人で行くのは不安だからです。
She's confessing to a strange guy like me. She probably has at least one or two friends, so why is it me again? Why is it a problem? Don't you want friends yourself, Tomoya? Especially a girl? You don't want to hang out Sunohara's all the time, do you? I narrow my eyes as I gaze up the hill. Well, it's only a short walk from here. Do what you want. I say that and start walking again.
待ってください!
What now? She's looking at me when...
Anpan.
Now, for those of you who don't know, this is actually, they didn't highlight this one to let us know. Anpan is actually a type of, I actually think I'm totally freaking blanking on the words right now. Anpan is actually a type of, a bread, and it's actually filled with, like, bean paste. Yeah, something we really don't have much over here, to be fair. She says. How should I respond to that? French loaf? That's my line. What, do you just like Anpan? Wait, you don't really like it, but you don't not like it, but rather you do like it. She's a roundabout person. Anything is fine with me. Let's go.
Hi.
Seems that reply cheered her up a bit. Her words were like a charm. Tatter, tatter, tatter. I continue to hear her footsteps falling behind me. Step, 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 step. Fucking class. See, I wish, like, class just went by on, like, a transition screen like that. It never worked that way. I mean, I slept a lot. But it never actually, like, just, whoop, one moment, teacher's there, telling us about things we should know, and the next, everyone's just chilling. Never works like that in real life. You should be lucky, Tomoya. You should feel lucky. You should be happy that your class has just passed the transition screen. The lesson ends with the ring of the school chimes. Fuck. Voice suddenly makes me turn my head. Fujibashi Ro? She's a class representative. Why is she so close to my face? Or rather, to be precise, she was voted in. If I remember correctly, she's Kyo's younger twin sister. Her eyes keep on darting back and forth as she comes by my desk. What? She presents a sheet of paper to me. Is this a love letter? Oh, man, watch it be a love letter. I doubt it's a love letter, actually. No one loves you, Tomoya. I didn't think you were that bold. You've got real guts to be giving me something like this. Then, a death threat? I don't think it's nice to just hand something like that directly to me. A challenge? Thud. Fujibashi's face reddens as she forces the sheet of paper onto my chest. Oh my. That's right, from homeroom, which you weren't at, because you were late, again. That's it? How boring. I take the printout, shove it inside my desk without looking at it. You know what, it could be like, hey Tomoya. We know that you don't come to homeroom, but we're going to give you all this money. But you're not going to look at the paper anyway, because you're a jerk. It probably isn't worth seeing anyway. What? Is there something else? Something on my face? Look at that. She wants you to come to school on time. It's none of your business, really. That's pretty cold. So, if you become the class representative, you can just talk about your other classmates' attendance, huh? What is wrong with Tomoya? Her eyes are becoming misty. You're making her cry. This is how freaking bad you are, Tomoya. This is how so just antisocial are. You're making the class representative cry because you're just so frank and rude. Maybe it was a little rough. Now, I'm gonna apologize. Sorry, spoke a bit too much.
Oi, Okazaki, 委員長泣かすなよ。姉貴が飛んでくるぞ。
Oh shit, her sister. Her twin sister? There's her older twin sister that's like older by like some minutes?
大丈夫です。泣いてませんから。
I don't think that's what she should say when tears are building up in your eyes. Hey, jackass, did you think she was maybe trying to convince herself that she wasn't gonna cry, so that she doesn't? At least they aren't falling from her eyes yet, so let's not do something that will make her cry. I think it's a bit late for that kind of reasoning. Well, I'll take your advice.
Hi. Demo, dekireba, chikoku shinai you ni shite kudasai.
With that said, Fujibayashi pulls a deck of cards out of her pocket. Then, she clumsily places the cards in her hand and shuffles them. That's my best impression of a shuffling noise. Eh? Clatter! She drops them! She dropped the freaking cards all over the ground. Make a mess. Is it like moan at us? She quickly gathers the scattered cards and tries shuffling again. Seems she got it right this time. She forms a badly shaped fan with the cards and presents it to me. Huh? What?
どうぞ.
You want me to pick one?
さんまい選んでください.
I have no idea what's going on, but we might as well go with it. I don't know what the hell's going on. Me either, Tomoya. Is she gonna show me a magic trick? Anyway, I pick out the three cards.
But
this isn't a magic trick. You're supposed to guess what the cards are. Here. She carefully inspects the cards I picked.
Okazaki-kun.
Is that so? She's trying to pick a fight with me or something? Hey, aren't you the one who told me not to be late? So what the hell?
あの、学校に来る途中、横断歩道を渡れなくて困っているおばあさんがいて、手を貸してあげていたら遅刻してしまいます。
Helping old ladies is something I do not see Tomoya Okazaki ever doing ever.
でも、たくさん感謝されて
Gratitude payment? He's not interested in those either. Wait a second. What's with this overly detailed fortune telling? How could you tell me that with playing cards? They're not even tarot cards. Exactly what kind of premise do you have based on signs and marks alone? Maiden's inspiration. Sixth sense and full power. Even more, she's pretty confident. Could it be that you don't want me to come to school?
そんなことないです. ただ, 占いでそう出ただけなので.
Fine. I definitely won't be late tomorrow.
え?
I'm just gonna ignore that old lady at the pedestrian crossing. You'll be late even if you didn't ignore her, because you're Tomoya and you're late and you don't help people.
それは良くないと思います. こ、困っている人は
Nope, I'll just leave her alone.
でも...
Ding dong, dang dong. Look, the bell's ringing, so back to your seat.
はい.
And now you have alienated her and yourself. Fujibayashi drops her held shoulders, looking depressed, and goes back to her seat. Jeez, I'm the one who's becoming depressed here. Why? You were in complete control of that conversation, Tomoya. You shouldn't feel depressed, because you made this happen yourself. You made her depressed and almost cry. What?
占い, あまり気にしないでください.
I shouldn't worry about it, but what happened to Maiden's inspiration? After saying that, she slowly returns to her seat. Maybe she really is trying to pick a fight with me. The result of the unusual fortune telling makes me worry a little. Moyo and Kazaki don't worry about shit. Third period has passed, and I lay down on my desk. There's a loud thud next to me. Looking up, I see Sunohara slam his bag onto the desk. What's wrong? Looks like you're feeling crappy since the early morning. That sounds pretty crappy. Then, isn't that okay? Isn't that good?
問題はその後だよ。僕は朝食を食べた後、コーヒーを入れて部屋に戻ってくるんだ。Sounds
like a good morning to me.
朝の穏やかなひととき、この時間が一番幸せを感じる時だね。Okay,
let's move it along. Don't have all day. Got classes to ignore.
僕はいつものようにラジカセの再生ボタンを押して コーヒーを飲み始める。BGMはお気に入りのヒップホップ。しかもこの世に一つしかないマイベストだ。いやー、優雅だね。Yo,
Amokazaki, you're... Forget it, this is stupid.
コーヒー吹き出しただろうが。なんでイカしたラップがお前のわけわからんラップに変わってるんだよ。Jacked
up rap. That was far from jacked up. Eh? That was my doing?
俺、岡崎って自己紹介してたじゃないかよ。
That wasn't me. That was a different Okazaki. Oh yeah, that's right.
あのテープは一本しかないお気に入りのベストだったんだよ。
I did that for you, so you should thank me for it.
あんなものうまくできていたとしても嬉しいわけないだろ。
Even if I did it well, I thought that was pretty good. Why is that? I tried to pick out good things about you and rap about it.
一つも浮かんでなかったみたいですけどね。
Well, I couldn't find anything when I tried, sorry.
すんげえ人の神経逆なでしてるんですけど。
Eh? Is that my fault? That I got on people's nerves? No, it's Moya. It's not your fault at all.
僕が悪いんすかね。 しかもお前、録音ボタン押しっぱなしで帰っただろ。
It's all gone. Everything.
この後もずっと消えてたじゃないかよ。
Who cares about that old music? It was crap.
あれが最高なんだよ。戻せよ。
Don't say something impossible.
CD また借りてこいよ。
Next time, I'll record your scream so you'll forgive me.
二度と取るな。触るな。 くそ。
You know why, Sunohara? It's because you didn't have tea. That's a good lesson for you, isn't it? Next time, set your important tapes as read-only. You should hide your precious things, then.
You
should have had tea for us. I think that's the main thing. If you had tea, I probably wouldn't have felt like being such a jerk.
Oh,
don't be so sad. He violently pulls out his chair and sits down.
What?
You just got to school. You were just sleeping a while ago, right? Someone ruined his morning. Saying that, he lays his face on the desk. Sleepiness is contagious, so I made a big yawn. Thus, fourth period passes, and I check the seat in front of me. There's a thin textbook, so next is English grammar. One of the subjects I don't like. This sucks. Being as though we are very much delinquent, and Sunohara is sleeping next to us, we're gonna skip class, because I don't feel like being next to him. It's not tea having ass. I sneak out of the classroom and head towards the old school building, as always. Like a stalker, I continue down the hallway. Almost all of the rooms here aren't used, and by request, they've become club rooms, but they're usually just left as is. Without further delay, I slip inside one of the empty classrooms, and then sit in a suitable chair. The desk, man. Suitable chair. The suitable chair is your desk back in your regular classroom where you were skipping. Beyond the curtainless window is the beautiful sky. Since I finally skipped class, the only thing I need to do is waste time. I murmur a little to myself and blend in with the empty room. I wonder if a life like this will someday change too. Will the day that something changes come? Getting awfully philosophical, eh, Tomoya? There was a person talking about that. Thinking of an effeminate girl was the only thing that came to mind. It was like, you just saw her like this morning. How do you forget? You lead a pretty miserable life, it seems, and you forget like the only girl that's talked to you, really. She even said like Anpan, and he made her smile, and you've already forgotten her. You're a jackass. I close my eyes. Wonder if something good will happen if I just sit idly here. Nothing good can happen. You're sitting someplace you're not supposed to be. Oh look, nothing good happened. A sunlight suddenly lands on top, right on top of me. It becomes unbearable and I open my eyes. It's the only thing existing in this empty room. I leave the empty classroom. Well, that was a waste of freaking time. Unconcerned, I go down the stairway. By the end of the corridor, I see a sliding door. It's the library. There's a written note saying closed. But if you look closely, the door is slightly open. I feel anxious for some reason. Look, a library. Open the sliding door and go inside. There are tall bookshelves and reading tables all lined up, like most libraries. There's a little wind coming in, mixing with the scent of paper and dust. The floating curtain is swaying back and forth, as if it's breathing. And over there at the window is a person's shadow. What?